In 3, 2, and 1, here we are!
Hey!
Hello. Hi!
You say fucking Geekoman?
Geekoman! Fucking.
Anyway.
Welcome to Badger's Burrow Podcast number 31. I'm Jamie.
I'm Alex.
And I'm Ross.
And we are Use Hosts.
We are Use Hosts.
Yep. And, I'm going to start off by saying, as of the day of recording this is the 25th anniversary of the World Wide Web. Not the internet, make that distinction, not the internet, but the World Wide Web. Good chat, guys.
Yeah. I don't know what you wanted to say about that.
Right.
Yay.
So, we've got this thing that lets us talk to each other.
Fucking in this
podcast. Without it, we would have never met, and this podcast would
and
not.
And there's me without
and
getting a cake.
Then who's to say that life wouldn't be better?
Well, how would life be different? Like, life
no,
would be
no internet mass. Trolls.
No internet trolls.
What would they do?
Fucking Blockbuster's not thriving.
Yeah. Think about all the poor people put out of work by fucking Netflix and shit like that.
Yeah. Bastards.
Yeah, probably TV would probably be doing a lot better, right?
Yeah.
Infinitely, yeah.
Yeah.
Fucking tree porn is a better thing.
Yeah.
Tree porn.
Yeah.
Yeah, bush and tree porn would still be a thing.
Bush porn.
Yeah.
Did you never do that?
No, I know what you're on about. It's just like...
You never went down to the local park and found porn and bush.
It's funny.
The look Jess just gave me.
Why isn't she in this podcast? She'd be as well, being.
Here's the thing, like, we've had this discussion a couple of times with women present, and they've always either called us fucking scumbags or given really disgusting looks. And I'm starting to think maybe that's just a guy thing.
What, bush porn?
The thing is, though, it's not us hiding porn in the bushes.
No, we just find it.
We just find it.
But I reckon there's other guys that have hidden it.
No, I think here's what it is, because it's always some of those shitty little newspapers that's like 20p. It's builders have bought them, got bold and just fucking thrown them away after the fucking shift, and it's just blown it into a bush. It's not like somebody's out there hiding it.
Seems quite sinister if someone's out, like, planting porn.
Bushes. Yeah, someone's out there planting porn.
Either like, that or they're, like... They're like doing a public service.
Somebody is setting up porn dead drops and the kids are out there interrupting them.
I just like the idea of like a little RC plane flying over and it just drops a bag loaded with porn. Fucking little smoke grenade goes off. Little 5-year-old wanders over. Oh, look at this. What the fuck's that?
Fucking guys are over some CB radios like, the package is away. Oh, fucking.
T-minus 30 to drop.
F only, man. Fucking F only. Can we start a porn network and just drop it off porn by fucking RC planes?
Ross has got that drone.
I've got a drone, it's doable.
Look, let's do it then, man.
Would we like to. I want to start getting some guests back on the podcast.
You want to start getting some guests?
Yeah. I think we've spoke about it a wee bit here, but I want to get some guests in on. I want Colin to come back. Colin would be good.
Yes.
Yeah.
I've been messaging Colin on Twitter, actually.
Oh, yeah, I've seen that.
Asking him.
Okay. Ross told us out already.
Yeah, was he not commenting or something, right?
Yeah, he commented, then I DM'd him. I slid into those DMs.
You did.
Like a pro.
Don't ever say that again.
Fine, I'll just go back to flying my RC porn drone.
As long as it keeps you out of mischief.
That's the opposite of being out of mischief.
That is causing mischief. That is like mischief prime.
Mischief prime.
Yeah, which man. Would be a fantastic Decepticon. But yeah, I've been messaging Colin asking him to come back. We just need to figure out a time that suits him.
I think we can get him back for the next podcast.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm calling it right now. Iron Lord the Mad on Twitter. Listen to this podcast. He probably will. You're coming back for 32.
And then, like...
I mean, providing he's available for 32.
Yeah, you're the one that's going to put out the message on Twitter saying that you couldn't uphold to your promise.
Yeah.
And that you now have to reject that statement.
Okay. Reject.
Reject.
I mean, I'll do it. I'm happy to do that. I'm happy to go for something that's just not possible and admit that it wasn't.
Good. As long as you're accountable.
Yeah, I'm fucking accountable as dicks.
Good. Dick's known for their accountability.
Yeah.
But absolutely not.
You can absolutely count dicks.
You can count them, but not accountable.
Millions of them on the planet.
There billions, technically.
Yeah.
Definitely millions.
How many are in use, though?
I don't know, fucking mine's not.
Are they not? They're not in use all the time.
No, but, well, what would you call like, its primary like, function?
Well, it's not
what's its prime objective?
Pussy.
Exactly.
No, you use it for peeing, though. Is that in use?
Would that not be a secondary function?
It's a secondary function.
But then there's a second, like, it doesn't, but it's not like you put it in storage or anything. Like, it's always there.
Jamie. It is a sexual organ. Its primary function is to acquire said puss.
Mm-hmm.
And then slay it.
And then slay it.
Yeah. Like, everything else is secondary. Nothing else matters. I'm single ladies, come get me.
He's a lovely person deep down.
What an advert. Alex, plenty of fish.
It's the boss one, plenty of fish, actually. If I can get it right, bitch. Is that what you usually? Yeah.
Him.
No, it's Mr. Possum. Uh-huh. Come at me.
Mr. Possum. You went for the classy.
What?
You went a bit classier.
I mean, if you want to get classy, my Twitter handle's name on Twitter is Mr. Wiggles. It's not very classy, let's be honest though.
I loved what you became.
Have you had, Alex, can I ask, have you had any luck chatting folk up with by asking the question, do dogs think of space yet?
No.
Are you still using that?
Absolutely.
Fantastic question.
It's pretty good, to be fair.
Yeah. I've had some responses to it, most of which are just being, you fucking stupid. A few of them have been like, oh, yeah, maybe. And I'm like, yeah, you're alright, aren't you?
That's the judgment if somebody's okay. No, not. Yep.
If they respond to a question like that with, are you fucking stupid, then I don't want to be with them. It's that simple.
Exactly, yeah.
It's a process.
I'm agreeing with you. I think it's brilliant.
Yeah.
Like, when one of them replies with, I don't know, what do you think, and you have a conversation about it, you go with that person.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So that's the kind of person that's on the dumb shit level as you.
That question, by extension, has got me coffee.
Yeah?
How many times? Yeah.
Once.
Then it's worked.
I was what doesn't.
Still worked. You got a coffee.
Did you speak about that question over coffee, though?
Yes.
What was the conversation?
Do dogs think of space?
Well, maybe. She brought up that show that was on some channel a while ago about like teaching dogs to fly planes.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I remember.
And there's like... Surely, like, they must think about planes, then. I mean, my dog used to watch planes, sometimes. But she was a little bit touched, let's be honest.
I'm sorry.
She had the worst laugh at my fucking dead dog.
Oh, I'm a bad man.
No, go for it.
Jamie gets it.
No, I'm laughing at you being just an inquisitive little cunt.
Yeah. I'm a bad man. Continue.
Yeah. Forgot where I was going with. All right, aye. So they think about planes and that, like, by extension, they must at some point think about space.
Yeah, it's a good point.
But then again, they're dogs. They don't know their fucking arse from their elbow, so who knows?
Some dogs know their arse from their elbow.
They lick both, though.
Yeah.
Have you ever licked your elbow, though? It could be tasty.
I physically can't.
Exactly. You don't know.
I don't imagine it's much different from, like, your arm, though.
It might be. The skin texture's different.
It's texture, not taste, though.
Yeah, but texture can mean a different taste.
Yeah. It can, like...
Yeah.
What if you can grip something with your elbow? Like...
What, you mean, like, by extension?
So, like, if your elbow's wrinkly enough, you press it against something and, like, straighten your arm, would that create, like, a suction?
Maybe.
Sunction. I don't think so. We need to find a dude with really wrinkly elbows and film him picking up like a playing card or something. I think that's the video.
That's a shit video, but okay.
Yeah, it's a shit video.
Nah. That's when we go viral.
Yeah, that's the video that does it.
Yep.
Yeah.
Fucking hell. Speaking of stupid videos.
All our hours of content that, you know, get very few views, but that one old guy picking my plane up his elbow, that's why I'm no ticket.
It's where we make our millions.
Funny if it was, wasn't it?
You do know that it's more likely to be a video like that than anything you put effort into.
Yeah.
Yeah, well.
Fucking. That's the World Wide Web for you.
Mm-hmm. Well, it was like that Success Kid thing that became a meme, and that ended up paying for the dude's fucking kidney transplant. So popular.
Mm. No, his dad's kidney transplant.
Yeah, yeah.
That's fair.
Because if they had a fucking National Health Service, wouldn't have to pay for shit.
True. Still a good story.
He could have pocketed all that money.
Mm. I'm sure that wasn't all of it.
No, yeah, I think he's probably earned more.
But how much is a kidney transplant?
A lot. I'm going to Google.
Exactly.
Google it. Save me fucking dough.
I can hear the clackety clack of keyboard there.
Keyboard.
Keyboard. Keyboard. Keyboard. Keyboard. Keyboard. Fucking, this is what this podcast has fucking disintegrated into.
We started on
£17,000.
What's that in space money?
70,000 credits. Yeah. I'm fucking though. I don't go to space, I don't know the fucking currency.
That's 2,000. No, 22,000 and a. $22,500, roughly.
It's a lot of money.
Yeah.
That is
in
a
space
lot.
Space news, though. Right?
Oh, you got space news?
I've got space news. Brilliant. Fucking. I've got NASA on Instagram, right?
Yeah.
And fucking. They put out a massive story the other day that I had to sit and watch it for like 20 minutes. It was fucking fascinating. It's like they're building a new rocket to go to Mars. Like they're fucking building it.
Is it?
I'm
one step closer to my dream of going to Mars and leaving all the fucking cunts behind.
Oh, yeah, are they manning that space flight?
It is for a manned space flight, yes.
Excellent. Is that going to be like the first manned space flight for... Well, it's not just gone to the International Space Station for a long time.
I believe so. I know China's planning on putting folk on the moon soon, again.
They'll just fucking make their own moon and do it that way. Fucking make it.
They probably are. They're halfway there. They've got to be.
What, I don't know why.
It's China. No, building a moon.
I don't know why, but for some reason, Alex, I just imagine somebody going up to the moon and finding a Made in China sticker on it.
I mean, I've joked about getting a hooded mask for years, man, so...
But yeah, like, they were showing off, like, they're building a new rocket and they're about to start testing the new booster, which is like a redesigned one of the space shuttle launcher. And the welder was the size of, like, a house.
It's like a big fucking welder.
Yeah, it's like the world's biggest welder was welding this fucking massive rocket into all its different pieces. It was fucking fascinating to watch.
But you really, truly are fascinated by space, aren't you?
Space is fantastic.
It's alright.
No, space is fantastic.
It's
alright. I've said it before and I'll say it again. If I could go into space and come back, I could die the next day happy.
What if you went into space and died up there?
Oh, even better.
Alright.
Get to float in space forever.
Question.
Space.
Or titties.
Oh, that's a good one. That's a good
space
one.
Space titties is an option.
Yeah, space titties is an option, because you could go into space and then find titties in space. But titties might not be as appealing in space because of the lack of gravity.
Yeah, but there could be more of them. Fucking Total Recall, man.
Yeah, there could be more of them.
But does the lack of gravity not present the opportunity for infinite jiggle?
And, like, no saggy, though.
Yeah, but it also... make some deadly weapons. If you get enough force behind them, you could kill a man with them.
I mean...
deadly weapons.
I'd be happy to go that way, to be honest with you. Jimmy, can we be a titty? Fucking go for it.
Jimmy, I know people that if they run without a sports bra, they knock themselves out. Those things are deadly. Fucking, one of them coming at you from the terminal velocity.
What is a terminal velocity with it?
I don't know. Let's do that math.
Let's not do math.
That would have to be terminal velocity of the human it's attached to, though, right?
Or no, just the what's the average weight of a tit?
Hang on. Google it.
Each breast weighs 1 to 2 pounds on average.
Right, okay.
That is about half a kilo.
Yeah. So what we need to find out is basically how fast can that fall before the wind resistance acting on it is equal to the speed. There we have terminal velocity.
Yeah, but the thing is, titties themselves are fairly aerodynamic, are they not?
Exactly, yeah. So it would go at some speed.
We're all about absolutely bizarre fucking calculations.
It makes life interesting.
Yep.
It makes life interesting.
Jesus Christ. That looks complicated to work out, if I'm honest. Ross, you're going to do the math and you're going to give us the answer in the next...
No, he's fucking not.
He will.
Where's my pen and paper?
He'll do it. Get this, Johnny.
He'll do it.
The math. No. I'm going to do it in my Love of the Force jar.
Love of the Force.
Yeah, Love of the Force.
Love of the Force jotter, though. Ross, we drove trucks.
We did, yes.
Or, well, singular truck.
Singular truck.
It was good.
A truck and a pickup.
Yeah. I suppose both could be counted as trucks. Just one much smaller.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was fun. That was a good day.
What did you say the average weight of a boob was, Alex?
About half a kilo.
Half a kilo.
The metric will be easier.
Gotta do the metrics.
Yeah.
Fucking period. Whoa.
Yeah, it was good. We went along and I had to go in the pickup truck towing a trailer first.
Mm-hmm.
And I fucking jackknifed it 3 times.
What?
But for someone who's got no driving experience,
yeah.
to get it on the fourth turn, I don't think it was too bad.
No.
And then Jamie, you went and had to go in the big truck.
I did.
It was a class 2 with a trailer.
Yep.
You got on very well.
Yeah, I'd managed to get it round and reverse park it not too difficultly.
Mm-hmm.
He said, if it was the mod 2 test that you'd done that reverse park in, I would have passed that bit. Because I got it in the box enough. Because apparently getting it pretty square in the box does not count. It's just about getting the entire back end of the trailer within a certain area.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, as long as you're within a fucking, what is essentially a loading bay.
Yeah.
Because let's face it, that's what these vehicles are for.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's what he was saying, and I was kind of a bit weirded out by it, because I'm just so used to driving and reverse parking and all about, actual parking bays, and when you don't get it right in a parking bay, you're a cunt.
But I don't know if I'm going to be able to do this math, guys. I've just looked at the formula.
That's what I said.
No, listen. I need to find, to get the velocity, I need to find the square root of the mass of the falling object, the acceleration due to gravity, the density of the fluid of the object. So what is the density of a tit, basically? The projected area, how big are this tit are we talking? And the drag coefficient. A lot of maths.
Some breasts are more dense than others.
Well, no, they're about as dense as each other. No, you know,
I'm not laughing at this, right? I've just stumbled across a site that's got boob density listed under a Brata base.
What's that? Fucking Brata base.
That is fucking awesome. Unfortunately, it doesn't give me an average. Actually, very sad.
The density would just be the density of skin and body fat.
I was about to say, the density of flesh would probably be...
No, it's bear in mind that a tit is 90% fat.
It's difficult math.
Yeah. I think anyway. I ain't no scientist. If there's anything proved in this show, I'm not a fucking scientist.
Do you want to talk about what we discovered when we were out at that truck driving experience, Ross?
Yeah, you can hire the airfield there. Or whatever you want to use it for.
So, essentially. Yeah. So what did you say that we would do?
I said we hire it out and shoot Alex with a paintball gun at high speed.
And maybe well, a dickhead fucking agreed to it.
No. To clarify, you said we should hire it and shoot a paintball gun at a mannequin at speed.
True.
And then Alex said, dibs mannequin.
Yeah, that's actually how it went down.
Yeah, that's exactly how it went down. Look, if we're going to do something stupid, something may as well get a fucking heart as well.
Mm-hmm. Well, do you know what's actually potentially more stupid? Me and Ross went out to the airfield on Sunday and seen the different areas we could rent.
No, that's not stupid. That's plan ahead. That's smart.
I think it's just fucking stupid that it was such a stupid idea and we actually went out and priced the airfield and now we've got a budget for it.
Yeah, we do. Yeah.
Ross is working on a kit list and we're just busy working on exactly what we're doing and what we're testing and how.
You don't think the guy was a little weird?
He was a little bit. He did say he would promote whatever video we made out of it, though.
Yeah, he did.
Fucking, he's in for a treat.
Yeah, because he was asking us, oh, what do you guys do? And, like, I was trying to really, not answer that question.
Yeah, like, you were being really queer about it. I was just kind of, I was going down the amateur film route.
Yeah, and then, he just kept asking it. Like, you just wouldn't take the hint that I don't want to fucking tell you.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, it's kind of like a sort of a Top Gear challenge thing. Because it was the closest thing to what we're actually doing.
Yeah, yeah.
And he kind of dropped it at that.
Yeah.
But
he was asking different questions about, what speeds we were using, whether or not we would be, expecting to drift the vehicles or anything as well, eh?
Yeah. Because he was like, I don't mind you going up and down at high speeds and that, just the one thing I'd ask you not to do is drift, so you don't tear up the surface. Because it is technically a runway we're on.
It is.
Yeah.
It is pretty torn up anyway.
Yeah, it's not the best of runways as it is, but
no.
Fucking it would do us for what we need.
It is, yeah. It's perfect, really. I'm honestly, I don't know what it's going to evolve into, but I'm looking forward to that shoot, whatever it becomes.
Yeah, same.
That is going to be a day well spent.
If I don't come back bloodied and bruised, I'm going to be upset.
See, the thing is,
I think it says a lot about me as a person.
I was worried you would be going back too bloodied and bruised.
Nah. No, I erred on the side of caution. Which I never thought I'd ever do.
No, I didn't expect that from you either, to be honest. You're normally the kind of person that's like, this needs an extra rocket.
Yeah, we need to... what we really need is a rocket tied to this. I erred on the side of health and safety when we went out there. And I elected to do it on the long stretch of runway with no buildings on it, rather than in the short bit of runway with buildings on it.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Also, Google can't answer my question, what's the density of a boob?
No, I was looking it up as well. Can't be found. Well, not easily anyway. I think we can work out the math for next time, though.
Yeah, we'll come back. Episode 32, we'll have it figured out. I've got the formula. I've got the formula jotted down, so we can come back to this.
Sweet.
Meet up on Saturday.
Yeah.
Can't wait, mate.
Right.
Can't wait.
Wait, math question, right?
Math question.
Oh, God.
The density of fat, which is the main thing of a boob.
Yep.
Yeah.
Is 0.09 grams per milliliter, right?
Aye.
How much fat is in a boob?
Depends on the cup size.
Well, let's say, what's the average cup size?
Well, no, we're...
These days, C, probably.
So yeah. A C cup. Right, so how much fat would be in a C cup is what we need to know.
Mm-hmm.
We're getting there.
That's a lot of work for a dumb joke.
It is, but at the end of the day, our listeners will know what the terminal velocity of a boob is.
Yeah, all five of them.
Yep, all five of them. And they'll thank us for it.
True. Because then they'll know. Fucking Colin Smart, you brought that.
Yeah, he is smart. He does test shit, doesn't he? Works in a lab.
Does science shit.
Well, yeah, we could give it to take to the lab.
Mm. Why take to the lab? Just fucking keep the numbers and be like, how you science boy do this?
How you science boy?
Science boy.
Science. Do you know what else we've been trying a lot recently? Which, one, we need to do a Let's Play, and two, we need to get some podcast footage in. We've been playing Destiny again, guys.
Yeah, we have.
Oh, sorry.
What are you laughing at?
I looked over to Jess and she's been running some figures for me. And she was like, what size? And I was like, I was trying to whisper to her, like, C-cup, do a C-cup, that's the average. She just points at her and goes, do mine.
You're marrying the right woman, Ross. You're marrying the right woman.
Okay, we've sat and figured out how much her tits weigh. She's not happy with me now. I really want to say, but she'll kill me.
Ross, yeah. When no, is...
I've been given the go-ahead.
Oh,
come down.
8.5 kilo together.
That's a lot of tit.
It's a lot of tit. She's got big boobs. I'm just waiting for the fucking club around the back of the head.
Yeah.
Waiting for her to actually get up on the mic and join in with a podcast.
Yeah, fucking... it needs to happen one day.
Nah, it's... I think it's funny that she's not on the...
There's more comedy in getting messages passed through.
Yeah, that really is funny.
Yeah, true.
And the threat of Ross being punched at any point.
Yeah, because you guys won't get to hear it coming. You'll just hear me go, ow.
If it's hard as measure, he'll slap.
Fuck you. Throwing fucking pen lids at me. Fucking, where'd it go?
Do I go ahead and move your coat there, Ross?
Nah, it's fucking staying with it.
I was wondering what I heard.
Oh, sorry, Pepsi.
This podcast not sponsored by Pepsi.
Although two of us are drinking it currently.
Other
may as well be.
Other soda brands are available.
Soda.
Pop.
Other fizzy pop. Drink. Jeg.
Yeah, it's fucking fizzy drink.
Such as Iron Brew.
Made from Girders.
Can you imagine if we could get a podcast sponsored by Iron Brew?
I'd be so happy.
Yeah. It'd be fucking great.
We should try and get another sponsor, actually. That would be good.
Jimmy, how's your dad no sponsor us? He's got his own business.
He's got a decent sir.
He'd get any business from it, would he?
I mean, what's he gonna like give people?
I don't know.
Comedy.
Yeah.
We talk about where he likes fucking plaster on a painting.
That was a great video.
It was. It's the long fucking pause, man.
It's the long pause as he thought about it.
Yeah.
That was a treat.
Fucking, you told me the other day that you've been telling your parents what I say.
Yeah, I have. I've been way more open with them about what I'm up to.
And their fucking responses are apparently quite interesting.
Yeah, they're pretty good.
Because like, I texted you the other day, didn't I?
Uh huh. Oh like, yeah, like oh yeah.
7 in the morning. It was like 7 in the morning or something. I texted you.
Yeah, do you want me to get the conversation up?
Yeah, go get the conversation up.
You
went and passed it on to your dad to see what his thoughts on the matter were.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. 7:53 a.m. on Sunday. Do you think lobsters are like mermaids to scorpions?
That was my question.
That was your question. And then I argued that it'd be like a uripitrid, which is like an extinct... like crustacean type thing that actually had a stinger, so I was saying maybe it was closer to that.
Mm-hmm.
But then you said the lack of a stinger would probably be the same as the lack of legs to a human, so that would be the mermaid part of it.
Yeah, that was my general thought.
Yeah, in which case then a lobster is probably the closest. But I did say to my dad that you'd text me that. He just gave me the blankest stare.
Like, I'm not surprised.
Like, part of him was trying to work it out. Part of him was just wondering what company I keep.
I mean, he's met us.
He has. On a few occasions.
Granted, I've been quite reserved and polite to your parents because, to be honest, I don't know them that well. Don't know what I can get away with.
Give it time.
Yeah.
It'll happen.
Although they'd almost fucking see what I'd... But I'd put in a... What do you call it?
Use those words. Need them.
Quiplash. Game we're having up at yours.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Do you know what my mum and dad actually said after that?
What did they say?
They were just like... They spoke to me like the next morning and they were just like, we didn't really understand the game you were playing like last night. Was the objective to be mean to each other? And I was like, no, but that ends up being funnier than actually trying to be funny.
Yeah. I'm just glad they fucking, like, with, especially with, like, what your mum does as a job, I'm glad that she didn't miss one of my fucking responses.
Yeah.
It's not something you just get to make a joke about and have it be, you know, okay.
To be fair, with what I do as a job, it shouldn't have been okay with me either.
Yeah, true. I say a lot of shit that shouldn't be okay with you, to be honest with you.
Yeah. I just kind of accept, like, my home life is different from my work life, though.
Yeah, absolutely.
You've got to have that distinction.
You do. You do. I mean, right now, I'm, in a way, struggling not to take work home with me because I'm the only fucking full-timer left at my work. Mm. There's a serious lack of staff. It's not good.
I'm going to speak to you about that after this podcast, by the way.
Yeah?
Yeah.
How come?
Just cause.
What's your job?
No. Not for me.
Well, I'm just kind of wondering, like, is it
after the podcast?
After the podcast. After the podcast. Again, I really enjoyed doing the Minecraft set last
time. Yeah, that was fun.
That was a lot.
Apart from all the technical hitches, that was fun.
Yeah, that was.
Had I not been like fucking dying of the lurgy, I probably could have enjoyed it more. But fucking hell.
Are you feeling better, by the way, Alex?
Talk about a cough, but all on that, I'm alright.
Fucking, I made a big boo-boo when we were recording that, by the way. I didn't realise I was editing it.
What? What did you do?
I never actually looked at the TV screen. I looked at my capture the whole time.
But
so I've got that delay.
Yeah.
So there are bits of it where it's noticeable that I react to stuff later on than when it happens on the, like, the screen, because I was watching it through a delay.
Oh, right. All right. I'm with you.
There's only, like, one point it's really, really noticeable. But
I was wondering why that was.
Yeah, it's because I had it up on my computer screens and the mic's on the desk, so I was like, fuck it, it means I'm pointing and speaking to the mic.
Yeah.
Rather than, like, looking at the screen and speaking to them aside.
Mm. Yeah, because that's what you'll be doing just now, is, like, looking at your screen and your mic the same as I am, even though there's not fuck all to look at on my screen, really.
Mm-hmm. I'm not.
You play an Xbox?
Playing Battlefield.
Well, that's like the kind of thing where my desk, like, if I want to play my Xbox, I have to do a 180 to see the TV.
Yeah. Mm.
So all the podcasts where I was sitting playing stuff, I was, like, speaking over my shoulder to the mic.
Yeah, you like, turn to speak to us.
Yeah.
Fucking Ross, the last time we recorded something over Xbox Live, by the way, when we did Rainbow Six, I suppose we can actually say that we did it. It's going to come out.
Yeah, it's going
to come out. Fucking, I think our audio setup for that was fucking awesome. It was such a simple change to make, but it made it so much easier.
What did you change?
Fuck knows, I can't remember.
We set our like mic levels through Skype and just listened to each other for a little bit, and we were like, right, yeah, this is good. And then we took off our, like, Skype headsets and everything like that, and just hit the Skype recorder, put on our Xbox headsets, and used the party, so we got a good mix of the actual game audio and ourselves.
Mm-hmm. Fair enough.
And just knew that the mics were going to pick it up okay.
Mm-hmm. Fair enough.
And it worked. It was such a fucking simple change to make, but it was such a fucking great idea. Because I could actually, like, especially in Rainbow Six, you need to hear that game properly.
Yeah, you need to hear the footsteps. You need to hear them, like, putting breach charges on the door, like, when they're coming for you and things like that.
There was so much better reaction. I actually felt just more like we were just sitting in a party, the two of us playing that game, Ross. And I felt like the conversation and the reactions were a bit more natural.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like when you have multiple sets of headphones on and you're very clearly sitting in front of a microphone, you start to panic about the fact that you need to be saying stuff all the time.
It's the kind of thing...
Bless you.
It's the kind of thing that, like, any bit of silence when you know there's a microphone in front of you seems like an eternity.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Take away the microphone and the silence goes back to being nothing.
Yeah.
See, that's what I got to think about how I record all this Skype stuff, is I'm just using my Xbox headset, so... It feels no different to just sitting in a fucking party anyway.
Ah, you all.
Which is why I'm so casual, but you're sitting fucking playing games.
Yeah, you automatically feel chilled.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's just because I've got that better quality mic. I would rather use it.
Yeah, I'm the same, to be honest, Ross.
I just got lost with the fucking setup.
I'm normally the one that's recording the actual audio part of a lot of these as well, so I have to actually set up my computer as well. Mm-hmm. Although, having bought my new capture card, fucking fantastically, I can actually sit and have everything on one screen because there's no fucking delay now for me.
Yeah,
you got the HD 60S, didn't you?
I did, yeah. I splurged the extra for it. It's so worth it. It saved me so much.
Mm-hmm.
Because, like, I was actually sitting recording Neverwinter footage, which will absolutely be the footage that goes behind this podcast. I was sitting recording that, and all I did was fucking throw my HDMI cable into the capture card and just brought it up on my screen and just hit record and then just moved my mouse into the top corner, and then the actual capture window goes full screen, and then I just play the game as if it's on my monitor. Apart from when I move my mouse, I immediately get control of my computer again. So it's literally just a quick like tap of the mouse, or I can nudge the keyboard or something mid-recording to check what time we're at.
Oh, it's not the fuck.
And then I can also have like the Skype recorder to make sure that that's okay and still receiving data. And there's a little like record thing in the top left corner to like to tell me that everything's still working right, even though I'm full screened. So it works really, really well. I've been using that rather than anything else. Like beforehand, I always wanted a second monitor.
Yeah.
To have all that on, just so that I could be like right in front of it right there. But with that, honestly, I feel like I'm doing fine with one. I still kind of want a second monitor for editing more than anything else, just so I can actually full screen a preview of it, because it's
different. Yeah, see, I would like a second screen.
Yeah, it's just difficult to get a scale right. Like, I often, if I'm putting graphics and like text and stuff in, I often have to put them in, get them roughly where I want them, and then watch that bit back in full screen to make sure that it's not too ridiculous, because like what looks like a good scale like on the small preview window is not a good scale when you blow it up, because you're like, actually no, that is way too small. You know, or oh no, that's not noticeable enough, or oh, that actually cuts out there when it shouldn't. It's all good. Oh, Alex, did you check out Battlefront yet?
No,
I forgot to as well.
Tell you what, since I've got my controller in my fucking hand.
Yeah.
I'll finish this game first, yeah.
Yeah. Well.
XP in it.
Because we, yeah. Well, we were speaking about the fact that, because they added two new maps, was that right, when they brought out one of the expansions?
When they brought out the first expansion, yeah, they added two new maps.
For the survival. And I imagine they're going to do the same again with Bespin, although I don't know if Bespin's out yet.
Bespin's already out. It's been out for like weeks.
Yeah, it's been out for a while. I'm sure we checked this before Bespin came out, and it didn't add anything in for the one before that.
Yeah,
we'll double check, make sure.
But Bespin actually added new maps and stuff, though. I'm sure the one before that didn't really.
No, the one before did add. It added.
Added multiplayer maps.
Added. I think it was two new maps.
But were they not on ones that were like already on planets?
No, they were already on planets that existed, but they were new maps.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
One was inside Jabba's palace.
Yeah.
And one was inside the garage for Jabba's palace.
Yeah.
So the world was there, but the map itself wasn't.
Well, that's what I'm...
I understand what you're saying, like, Bespin's a whole other planet.
Yeah, the reason that they added new ones before was because they had added new planets completely, which is why they added completely new survivals. So I reckon they're going to do the same again.
Which, possibly.
To be honest, is great, because those survivals actually come out for free. So we don't need to buy the DLC to be playing additional survival maps. Pardon me. My God.
Yeah, it's like...
Which is great,
it's
honestly.
It's a nice balance.
It is, yeah. It's a good...
I would quite like to go and do a Battlefront Let's Play. Like, just us playing multiplayer.
Yeah, it'd be good.
Yeah, that would be quite good, actually. Just trying to get, like, three or four screens going for that.
Yeah. Game's loading just now, so I'll let you know briefly.
I do.
Lucasfilm LTD.
Fucking who's excited about Rogue One?
I'm pretty excited.
Fucking shock horror, I am.
Nah, no. So no shock nor horror, to be honest.
I'm more excited about the fact that I'll probably see you guys in the actual film itself. I don't really care about it, if I'm being honest with you.
I care about it less than, like, I'm going to care about episode 8.
Go.
I've just
had someone go on too long about it recently for me to like give a fuck.
Yeah.
See, I love Star Wars. Star Wars is probably my favourite like film series.
Familiar.
Any more of it, and I'm just a happy bunny.
And like you must have been fucking wet in the bed the night that they said that they were going to release 6 new movies, not 3.
Not gonna lie, I rubbed one out.
It's only those two maps that they're added. They also didn't add the new planets. It's on Hoth and Tatooine.
Fucking, the look I just got for Jess, she's like, the fuck are you talking about?
Can you fucking blame her?
No, but it's good that like she just looks at me, questions me for a minute, and then just accepts it.
Yeah.
Hoth and Tatooine are the new survival maps.
Yeah.
So there's only two then to do.
No.
You're a fucking idiot.
We'll get four still to record. I think.
How have we possibly got four still to
record? Jamie.
Yeah.
They've brought out two new maps.
Yeah, but they're on planets.
They're on two old planets.
Right, okay. So that gives us four in total still to do.
Yes.
I think so.
Brilliant.
I can't remember what the last one we recorded was. So
the last one we recorded was the original Hoth one, which ended the original four.
Then we get two still to record.
So I was right in saying that there's not actually new ones.
Why don't we talk about this afterwards?
Yeah.
Jamie's in the same room as me so I can strangle him.
Yeah. Because Ross gets what I'm saying, but Jamie seems to not. Fucking dullard.
I mean, I think I get what you're saying.
What am I saying?
You're saying we've got to record.
Yes.
How many maps in total are there?
Six.
Then we've got two to record.
Right.
Nothing hard about that. You were the one that confused it by saying there was four.
Fucking moving on.
I forgot how many we've recorded.
Moving on. Before I kill one of you.
Fucking him.
Or both of
them. Yeah, it's probably going to be Jamie because he's closer. It's less travel time for me to murder.
Plus he's got his address. You do have my address.
I do have my address because I sent you a fucking French fancy in the post.
And two beers. That almost killed me.
Yeah.
I'm gonna need your address sooner rather than later, actually, Alex, because we're coming down to yours soon.
All right, here it is.
I honestly, I don't know why. I really expected you to read it out. I got really wide-eyed. I was like, no.
Jamie,
I would have liked if you read out someone else's address.
Yeah,
just a random address.
Good, boss. Yeah, but like, I quite pulled up my phone. I was like, have I still got what's your face's address? That's not how you spell that.
Are you sending it to me now of all time?
Yeah, you've said that, means I'll fucking do it while I remember.
Fair enough.
Good point.
It's a good
system. I'm even giving you it in format.
It's a good system.
Yeah.
Yeah, do shit when you're asked to do it.
Yeah.
You know what I like?
Butts.
Butts and boobs are good. Yeah, we've been getting back into Neverwinter.
We have. I've been
wanting to play an MMO with you guys for so long. We're finally getting into it again.
It's quite fun.
Just took me one night for that to happen.
Mm-hmm. How did I accidentally end up with you on that, Alex?
We're just playing it and talking. You had like wanted to play a game. That's just Neverwinter. You came play Neverwinter with me.
Yeah, we've been playing.
Steven appeared, then Ross appeared.
Yeah. We've been playing Destiny.
The cycle was complete.
It's like I really want a decent group to play the Old Republic with as well.
Fucking this is your group.
I want a computer that runs Old Republic.
True.
Without burning the house down. That's my only prerequisite.
Can one computer... No, it couldn't.
Can what?
I was about to say, can one computer
run it twice?
Yeah.
No. Not that it fucking matters, Jamie.
Yeah.
Silence. But no, it couldn't because, well, it can only run the one program once.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Unless you're partitioning it, and that's a whole fucking thing.
Yeah.
I could do that.
Okay, but then Alex would have to be sitting in the same room as you to play.
Yeah.
To be fair, like, that's more likely at the moment than not.
I was waiting for it.
I mean, it's more likely for him to do that and be able to play the game with us than, like, by the time he gets himself a new computer.
Ah, yeah, because I'm broke, I get it.
You applied for a new job today.
I did. Not going to say what it was because security reasons.
Yeah.
But I did.
I hope you get it, honestly, man.
Yeah, I hope I get it as well, so it's fucking awesome.
Yeah, it's a fucking fantastic job, is what it is.
Yeah.
Is it good pay?
I don't know. 4 hours a week, though.
Ah, that's probably going to be pretty good.
It's one of the ones where even like it's not they legally can't pay me any less than I'm getting now anyway. So, you know.
True.
No complaints.
Yeah, you'll be sorted.
Yeah.
I can finally get a new fucking car.
Ross.
Yeah.
Can we please talk about you forcing me to do something the last podcast?
Yeah, fucking Ross had to get his whole fucking Jimmy wasn't for it. He went in dry, man.
What did I force you to do?
You forced me to fuck up the intro.
I didn't. Why would you like that?
You shut the fuck up. I didn't make you do shit.
I will not be silenced.
You fucking will be.
The truth shall be known.
Just fucking watch. I will kick you from this call. And I'll be that.
I mean, you can, and then there's just an abrupt end to the podcast. There's just silence.
Yeah.
My mouse is hovering over the remove person from this group, but don't make me press it.
I won't do nothing.
You good.
That...
Aha. Alex is not me.
I hate that shit.
What, double
the whole, I didn't do... Yeah, fucking don't let us fuck me the fuck off.
Well, again, you should try doing what I do for a living. You get it constantly.
Mate, if I did what you do for a living, I'd be in jail.
That sounds so wrong.
There would be a fucking body count. No, you mean yourself. There would be a fucking body count.
Fucking Alex.
Sounds like I'm like self-employed bank robber or something.
No, see...
I'm not, by the way. Just get that out there.
I also know what Ross is laughing at, and I'm not that either.
You say that, we keep coming back to it.
You keep coming back to it.
Yeah, but you keep allowing the conversation in that direction.
I don't allow shit.
You seed what I grow.
You seed.
You're giving me the ammunition to fire at you.
Fucking.
Glack, glack, glack.
Oh, no.
Just got a fucking message in Xbox for Chris.
Yeah, I got the same. I imagine it's a clip.
There's GTA. Ah.
I've been enjoying playing that a lot more again with you guys too.
Yeah, it's been fun.
I finally hit 100% gamer score in it the other night.
Do you know what my favourite thing about that was though, Ross, was how many achievements there are, and you only just pointed that out to me the other day.
Yeah, 69 achievements in GTA 5. I've got all.
I really hope they don't add any more. Like, it would be so Rockstar not to do it.
Yeah. I feel like, if anything, they added more to get it up to 69.
Probably, to be fair.
I can vouch that they probably did.
Because some of the achievements they added were, to be honest, not really achievements.
Yeah.
A lot of achievements in games these days aren't really achievements. I just kind of like, oh, you just lost the game.
Uneven achievements. Fuck them. Fuck
them. Oh, yeah.
I forgot about this. I hate them. Oh, so, can we speak about that as well?
If you fucking want, I mean...
We've not got an embargo on it, fucking
why not? Why not? I downloaded Overcooked because I fancied doing a Let's Play in. Because I thought it would be funny as fuck. Which I still maintain, I think it will be a great series that we definitely need to get Jess in on.
Yeah.
That'll be a treat.
Oh, yeah, get the woman in the cooking game. Why don't you get a fucking sexist?
She's in Cloudberry as well.
She has said herself that she wants to play that game.
Well, brilliant. Fantastic. That works out perfect then.
She's choosing to do it.
Excellent. Is she coming back for Cloudberry?
I think she wants to. We're talking about playing Overcooked. Remember the one with all the wee chefs that run around and it's madness?
Yeah. I like how she probably responded really quietly, so she wasn't on the mic. But yeah, like, downloaded that, so I booted it up just to see what it was about, see if you could play it like single player, and just get a bit of a feel for the game before we went into it, so I could know like title screens and stuff like that.
Uh-huh.
Just normal kind of game prep, and to see like kind of like what the embargo, if any, was on using it for game footage. But there's a fucking disclaimer right at the start that says use this game. It's brilliant. Absolutely love that. Team 17 as well. Same folk that did Worms. Which, by the way, there's a new Worms out.
Yeah, there is. It looks awesome.
Yeah.
Worms. Yeah, it's Worms WMD. You can actually like fly helicopters and mechs and tanks now. It looks fucking awesome.
Yeah, and you can get 8 worms on a team, I think, now as well.
It's like you can have 8 players with 8 worms each.
That is excessive wormage.
It is very
I
much.
I think it's only on PlayStation.
No, it came out on Xbox One.
Oh, well. Did it?
It came out.
I know it was on PlayStation first.
It was on PlayStation first. I'm sure it's
everything these days, man.
I'm gonna.
Fucking Sony just throwing that cash around.
Yeah. Yeah, it's on Xbox One.
Sweet.
I'm gonna see if it's available to buy in the UK right now. Yes, it is, and awesome. It's only available as part of a bundle.
What's the bundle?
WMD All-Stars. Which contains the game and that. Don't understand what the All-Stars bit is. £20. It's not bad, actually.
No, that's not bad.
Fucking the Attack on Titan game comes out on Friday.
Jesus, it's got 60 reviews and it's got 4.9. Out of 5, to clarify.
Yeah, we assumed.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Attack on Titan game comes out. Is that Friday? Did you say that?
Friday, right? Yeah.
It's good, by the way. You're really going to like it.
Good, because I'm going to fucking buy it when it comes out. I'm going to be sat at work and I'm going to use the Xbox Smart Glass to buy it and download it when I'm at work.
I fucking love that.
It is a fantastic feature.
I've done it so many times now. I'm actually converted to digital games purely for that kind of shit. It's the same as, like, I was looking at buying Forza Horizon 3 because I'm just, like, a fucking stickler for that series. I'm going to buy everyone and play probably a fair amount of it. And I was kind of, I was doing my normal divvying up what's best, whether to get the physical copy or the digital copy.
Uh-huh.
But I've finally kind of been swayed round by the instant switching, because it will be on my hard drive. The no disk errors, at least for me. I have that fucking issue with my Xbox. And the fact that I can preload the game so I can play it the second it's out.
Yeah, you started going digital after I pointed something out to you.
Yeah, you did, because whether it's delivery cost or the cost of me actually going somewhere to get something,
it outweighs the extra that they add on to digital.
Absolutely does.
It's like they add on, what, like £2-3 up to like £5 for digital?
Yeah,
it's not that.
Yeah.
And that would be like, you'd be £2-3 to park in the town.
Mm. Plus your £2-3 up to a fiver to actually go there and back in petrol.
Exactly.
Which more than covers the cost. If you're paying delivery costs, then you're normally a couple of quid for that as well. Or even worse, if you get free delivery, you're normally waiting a fair bit. Sometimes you manage to get it, to be fair, if you pre-order something like that, you can normally get it on the release day from Amazon.
Yeah.
They're normally pretty good about it.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just one of them things, isn't it?
Yeah, because fucking Rise of Iron is going to be the first thing I've pre-ordered in a while. I'm not actually pre-ordering it until like fucking end of this week. But I'm pre-ordering it digital, which to me doesn't make sense, but I want that skin for my Alahorn.
Yeah. I'm honestly, me and Ross were speaking about this when we met up to go to the airfield.
Mm.
I don't know if I'm going to get it.
No, neither do I.
Fair enough.
It's just, I've said it before, I'm enjoying trying to do the raid. I am enjoying that. But there's nothing that makes me want to play Destiny apart from actually going on and doing that with you guys. And I think that's still going to be the case when it's Rise of Iron. I'm not going to want to sit and put time in unless it's with you guys. I might be more persuaded to get it if all of you guys are fucking playing it.
Well, you know for a fact me and Chris are going to play it.
Yeah.
I think Steven's looking to get it as well.
I'm just not sold on it. Like, I've spent so much fucking time on Destiny.
Mm.
Like, it's time for a change. Like, I hate the sort of grind for a chance to get a level up. I don't mind a grind if it's guaranteed levels, but
I love that shit, man.
It's kind of the chance based stuff just frustrates.
Don't get me wrong, the how leveling up worked in Taken King bugged me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it really did. Like having to get maybe 3 or 4 pairs of the same fucking item just to get to the max of it. shouldn't fucking happen.
Yeah.
I'd like to see them go back to a system like they had year one.
I did.
Which
like,
I know they fucking won't. Yeah. But that system even worked.
Yeah, I like that system.
Yeah.
I did like the system of, you know, you can get up to a certain level without doing the high-end content, but you're only going to hit the max level by doing the high-end content on hard and getting the drops from it.
Yeah.
And those random drops were then sort of acceptable because you were always working towards it.
Even with Crota, you didn't need to do hard mode to get max light. You could get everything you need from...
That's true, actually, yeah. That's true.
Normal mode. It was just fault of glass that you had to do hard to get the helmet from.
Yeah. And then they had, what was that? What the fuck? When Prison of Elders came out, they basically gave everybody the opportunity through Prison of Elders to hit max level with whatever gear they fucking liked.
Yep.
Because they could upgrade it.
Yeah, you could ascend it or whatever it was.
Yeah.
It was like, was it not Aetheric Light?
Yeah, you used Aetheric Light to ascend it up.
Mm-hmm.
Which was great. It made all the Vault of Glass stuff relevant again.
It did. And I think that was honestly a really good system because there was so much of that gear that was really fucking cool.
Yeah, like, see if I could get Fatebringer back, I'd be so fucking happy, but it's not going to happen.
Vision of Confluence for me, honestly, like, that was just a fucking great gun.
I was a hand cannon slut.
Fucking, I miss my Crypt Dweller. That was a fantastic scout rifle.
Oh, yeah.
I miss that thing.
Yeah, other gear was good.
I do like the Hung Jury scout rifle, though. I'm a really big fan of that one.
I'm starting to go off it.
For the design of it alone, I like it.
I do like that it's got bubbles in it.
Yeah. It's a good gun as well. But, yeah, I'm just not a fan of the system that's in place at the moment. Like, I'm not a fan of, like, pushing to try and get all of that stuff.
Yeah.
And ultimately, you are just getting the fucking chance that something's a higher light level than you're currently wearing.
Mm.
And even though everybody was saying that they've changed the drop rates and stuff and it is more likely, it's still fucking really unlikely.
Class items were the one that was holding a lot of his back. Chris especially, like, he just could not get a cloak to drop with a fuck. Mm-hmm. It took him grinding something for ages to actually get it.
Was it last night? When we were doing hard mode Oryx, the drop I got from that was a 320 cloak.
Yeah.
The cloak I was wearing was like 323, I think.
Mm-hmm. Because you didn't get the hard mode drop, you got the normal mode one.
Yeah.
Which is capped at 320 anyway.
Mm-hmm.
It just, because mind, it's the same one with the old grids. Like, if you'd done hard mode before normal, it would drop, you know, more items. You get a normal mode and a hard mode drop. That's what it's done there. But it's dropped to the normal mode cloak rather than the hard mode one. Which I got last night. At fucking 334.
I got...
No, 335 even.
For my Warlock, I got two bonds. One was obviously a normal mode one and one was a hard mode one. And the hard mode one was like 6 light above what I had, which was decent, I suppose. But it was a bit of a slog. It's still... Yeah. Like,
I'm
only just 320 from having jumped back on and been playing... pretty consistently for nearly 2 weeks.
Yeah.
To jump from, I think, 316 to 320.
Mm.
Like, for 2 weeks worth of work, that does not feel like it's progress.
Yeah. Like, it's like smart loot or something they're calling the system they've got now, which, yeah, it's got its benefits, but overall, it's got more flaws than benefits, I've found.
Yeah, I know where you're going with that. I know what you mean.
It's just...
How long have we been going, Jimmy? Just FYI.
58 minutes.
Ah, we're getting close.
Yeah. We are getting close. I was about to start my wind down speech in just a couple of minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Just after the hour mark.
Yeah.
How are you guys finding the podcasts at an hour, by the way?
Yeah,
I like it.
I've got to say, I do agree with you guys now. There's a way better flow to them.
Fucking tell you.
You should
listen to your staff, Jamie.
I do.
Good.
I mean, we took majority vote. I was happy with it.
Mm-hmm.
Always that happens. I'm excited to get some sort of new pairings and some new videos and stuff going out and going on. We've got quite a lot of new ideas floating about at the moment.
I stand by that we need to finish the series we've started before we
Yeah.
Me and you anyway, Ross, definitely.
No, I think the whole channel, because fucking, it's, it annoys me looking at it, seeing like something like Alien Isolation, and then to watch it, you have to wait like fucking 8 weeks or 6 weeks or fucking however long it is to see the next bit.
Yeah.
It's fucking irritating me.
So, like, what, in an ideal world, Ross, what is your ideal system that we start a series on a set day of the month and do it until it's finished? Unless there's some, unless there needs to be some kind of special or something that overrides it.
Well, the way I looked at it is, like, Chatterbox is a prime example.
Mm-hmm.
We recorded it in the space of, what, 2 weeks?
I'd say, I'd say a month, to be fair.
Okay, a month. Well, it's essentially 4 weeks.
Yeah.
That was over a year's worth of content.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Just because we focused on that.
Just because we focused on that.
Yep.
And now, up until, like, we don't have to worry about that until February next year.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So that gives us more time to do other shit.
Yeah,
like
if we could
do that more.
Especially if we can do it more with online games like that.
Mm-hmm.
If you know what I mean by that, like where we can all sit at home and just collate footage at a later date.
If we could do that, then that would be fucking fantastic.
That would be
a lot of it comes from the one video a week cycle we've got, which granted we can't really do anything about.
I would honestly, Alex, I would really like to do something about it, but it's just a pure time commitment from all of us. Sometimes we can get pretty tight on deadlines, even as it is. A lot of the time we're way ahead of ourselves and we can kind of get to the point where we're thinking, oh, we've got loads ahead of ourselves, we'll be fine, but then stuff comes up and then meetups get delayed and recording dates don't happen. And there's a lot that goes on that prevents us from actually getting content together.
Yeah,
which we work in like a quick burst mode. Like we do loads and loads and loads, and then we're sort of settled for like 6 months. We do nothing or very little for 6 months, and then we do a really quick burst again, and we're done for the next 6 months.
Yeah, but
I wouldn't even say it's like that, to be honest, Ross. I would say it's more of like we actually get together to actually film the stuff for the next sort of 3, 4, 5 months in one sitting. For certain series and stuff like that, we get that going. But in terms of the next sit down is always so far later on because you need to sit down and actually edit that.
Mm-hmm.
Like you need the editing time and the production time to kind of get that up and out there.
Mm-hmm.
There's always going to be time in between our actual recording dates, no matter if we just stick to certain series.
Yeah. I think we just need to sit and figure out how we can get a series finished without it dragging on for too long.
Yeah, well, why don't we sit and work that out after this podcast?
Yeah, we could do that.
And come up with a plan whether that will start. Let's be honest, it's probably going to start next year at this point.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Just to give us time. Yeah, we can, because we can set the plan to finish off the series that we're going on, or at least get a scheduling for them. That suits them better, and then work on stuff for next year.
Yeah,
that sounds good to me.
Right.
Let's go and do it. If you enjoyed this podcast, head over to badgeandpals.com. You've got links there to all of our other stuff. You can check out the store on Redbubble, which has many garments that you can purchase. And please do. And if
some more will be coming soon.
Some more will be coming soon. We've got stuff in line. And I suppose from us it's all goodbye, and if you've liked this video, remember to like it and share it
or don't, whatever.
Bye.
Bye.